Hey everyone, I'm Justin, and today we will be reviewing how to add and subtract integers. Let's do it. So before we can begin learning algebra, we need to review some basic arithmetic. In this video, we're going to be talking about adding and subtracting using the only thing that matters in the world, money. Okay, I guess food matters too. And math also matters. And reading is important. I'm getting ahead of myself. Money, we're talking about that. And for now, we're just gonna focus on integers. So that is numbers that don't contain decimals or fractions. So let's pretend for now that money only comes in nice, crisp dollar bills, no like cents or anything. So if you earn money, or you already have it, that is a positive amount in your wallet. We would call this a positive integer. If you owe money or you pay for something, that money is subtracted from your wallet, and we would call that value a negative integer. So what does it mean to subtract a negative integer? So think of it like this. A negative amount means you paid for something. Subtracting is like going backwards. So if we undo paying for something, then you are going backwards to before you bought it. So in other words, you're getting your money back. So subtracting a negative amount actually adds the money to your wallet. This will be important to know. Two negatives kind of fuse to make a positive. So now let's take a look at some cases that combine having and owing money. Let's say that you owe $6. But you have $8 in your wallet. After you pay the $6 that you owe, you will be left with $2. But what if you owe $11, but you only have $6 in your wallet? Then you give up everything in your wallet and you still owe another $5. Oof. So both of the previous examples involved adding a negative with a positive. The rule of thumb here is that the result will keep the sign of the largest number. So if you have more than you owe, you still have money left over afterwards. But if you owe more than you have, then you can't pay off the debt yet, so you still owe money. Now, if we spend money on multiple different items, the negative amounts combine. So for example, if you buy a pair of pants for $20 and a shirt for $14, then you have spent $34 total. You are out $34. So if you already have $4 in your wallet, and then you return an item that originally cost you $8, then you'll get an $8 refund to add to the $4 in your wallet, making $12. So remember, when we subtract a negative, we're really just adding the positive. We're doing it in reverse. So what if we owe money and we have to return items in order to pay our debt, right? So if you owe $4 and you return a $9 item, then you'll get back that $9 refund and immediately pay off your debt, leaving you with $5. So notice again how minus a negative turned into a plus, making the transaction a lot easier to understand. So quick recap, because we've covered a lot. Positives are money you have. Negatives are money you owe or pay someone else. Adding two positives or two negatives just results in a bigger number with the same sign, positive or negative. Adding a positive and negative keeps the sign of whichever amount was bigger. And finally, subtracting a negative is the same as addition. It's important for us to understand adding and subtracting integers so that once we get into algebra, we can keep track of all the positive and negative signs that are going to be flying around. In our next video, we'll review multiplying and dividing with positives and negatives, as these will also be major components throughout algebra.